So we will use the matplotlib library to create Python charts. Scenario one, we'll be using the built-in sample dataset. So import the matplotlib library. You got to install it if you haven't done that before. And I'm also using the seaborn. So you notice that I'm calling it as SNS. So it's just an alias. You could have used anything. I'm using SNS. You could have used ABC, etc. It doesn't make any difference. So with that, we have the iris dataset, which is a sample dataset available. Let's load it up. And now let's print the data. So we have some data for the iris flowers, sepal length, sepal width, and the species. So we'll be using the species and we'll be calculating the average petal length. So I'm saying data.groupby on species. So we have three species, Setosa virginica, and there's one more. And then we're going to calculate the mean of the petal length. And that's it. We'll be using this data set. So if I run it, you would see that we will get three rows of data, Setosa and the mean, and various color and the mean, and virginica and the mean. So with that, we are ready to plot our first chart. So let's use the matplotlib script to do that. I'm setting the figure size to 8,6, and then I'm saying plot or plt.bar and average petal length index and average petal length values. And I'm giving three different colors for each of those species and giving it a title, X label, label on the X axis, Y label, label on the Y axis. And then finally, you have to say plot.show or plt.show. So we've got a chart for each of those species and their average petal length. So that sounds good. Now, what if we go and change the plot figure size? We can do that and the plot will become smaller. And you can also take this chart to your Word document. So you can copy it to clipboard. And once you copy that, it's available to you. Open your Word file and then simply paste it there. And if you want to go and change your figure size again, I'm changing it to a bigger one now. And you can repeat exactly the same thing, copy to clipboard and take your chart, which is already sitting in your clipboard, and paste it up in your Word document. So the second scenario is to manually create the data. And how do we create the data? We're saying species are these three species and the average petal length is these values. With that, we have our data. So I'm going to use exactly the same script and just change what we want to display on the x-axis. So on the x-axis, we are going to display the species. And then on the y-axis, we go to display the bars based on the petal length, the mean value, which is this. And then obviously we have three different colors representing each of those species. So let's run this chart. So this is our second scenario and we have created the data manually. And the third one would be, how do we create the data or create a CSV file and then import it? So I've already created a CSV file. I'm going to use the pandas library for the interaction with the CSV file. So the command is pd.read_csv, and this is the path of the file which contains our CSV data. So let's now run this command and print our data. So we got our data, it contains four countries and the average temperature for those countries. And notice that I've used the backslashes, two backslashes to separate the path, and now I'm using one forward slash. You can use either of those techniques to define your path on the Windows. So now let's plot this. So we can change the figure size if we want, like we've done previously. Now, to represent the data, so the first column is the country column, which contains the x-axis values, and y values would be the average temperature or temperature. Notice that I'm using average temperature. It has to be exactly the same what's in your CSV file. So in the CSV file, I'm calling it as temperature. So I've got to use that. And color, I'm just using one single color, cornflower blue. Let's run this chart. So here we go. And if I wanted to change the color to a different one, I could have done that. And we'll also see how we can change colors for each of those different species. So I can define another, exactly the same concept or style that we've done before. I'm using 5 different colors now. So I'm saying color equals the colors which we have just created. So it has given us 5 different colors. So I hope you found this information useful and practical. Thank you very much for watching it, and I'll see you in the next one.